When I was in the heart hospital, I'd had my heart stopped, so I'd literally been dead for minutes. Lying there in my hospital bed in pain, I watched someone in front of me who was dying. And as I lay there on morphine, I had a vision of this dark angel, chooser of the slain, going over my head to the next bed and taking the next person. And the painting is a kind of thank you to the dark angel, saying, you know, thank you for leaving me alive. Every single picture in this room relates to death in some way, because, you know, that is what I'm fighting against. I know at some point that my life will end. You know, the biggest impetus to life and creativity, to think about destruction and death. You know, the fear of death is so exciting for us. It makes us live that much more. And that's why we all go to Halloween parties or zombie marches or wear skulls on our t-shirts. I became very interested in the power that symbols had over people, and slowly but surely, by making these portraits, I developed my own kind of private symbolic language. And I began to photograph people at clubs who would go along dressed up to a club, looking like Jesus or wearing a, you know, a hat with a record. And I was so excited to see other people's creativity, and all this creativity was being lost. What I wanted to do was try to preserve it. And so I'm very interested in people making themselves up as a form of expression, as a form of rebellion against a very authoritarian society. I'm interested in the way that that connects not only with politics, but connects with our primitive nature. People that I paint are people that I think encapsulate that idea well. I call them my goddesses. And it's as if I'm a primitive worshipping these people when I'm painting. I paint them, and as I paint them, I grow to love them more and more and more, until the images become mine.